Hey there, Chelsea here, Monarch Alley. I'm a vintage lover, thrifter, and part-time reseller, and today I have my weekend what sold video for you. I'm excited about this one. I have $160 in sales, which for a part-time reseller, not bad. It's pretty consistent with what I like to see. I also sold two items within 2 days of listing them, so I've got some bolos for you. One you might expect, the other maybe you wouldn't. And then also, I sold on three different platforms. I sold on Poshmark, eBay, and Facebook Marketplace this weekend. So yeah, good weekend, and I'm really happy with it, especially because I'm preparing to go on vacation. This time next week, I will be in Colorado. I'm so excited. I do hope to do some videos while I'm in Colorado and do some thrifting as well, but of course, I'll be with my family, and we'll just kind of see how that works out. So anyway, let's get into what sold. First thing I have are these Dansko clogs. These I have in a thrift haul from a while ago, actually. These kind of took a while to sell. They had some good attention, but I think what was holding them back is that one is sun faded and the other's a little darker. And so, yeah, I think just that kind of the look there is what slowed down the sale. So I finally had someone like these recently on a Poshmark closet clear out day. And I actually just reduced the price by like 20%. So they got to like $17 and someone went ahead and picked them up. Now the benefit of Poshmark's closet clear out day is if you reduce the price by at least 10%, the people that have liked that item will be notified that you've reduced the price and they'll get discounted shipping of only $4.99. So that's a huge benefit to the buyer and definitely an incentive for them to make the purchase. And I think that's what happened here. I kind of went for it and just reduced the price and someone finally bought them. So really happy with that. Those are going out today. They're quite heavy actually. So I'm glad that they are going out on Poshmark because you can ship up to 5 pounds at the same label. So that's really great. So yeah, I like to picture that someone's going to be doing like a lot of gardening in those shoes. Do you ever kind of make up backstories for the items that you sell? I have a few of those for today's items. Next I have this hat. This, I think it was also in a recent thrift haul and it's really fun. It says pop on it. And this like has elastic or not elastic, sorry. It has like a bendy metal brim. So you can just kind of mold it how you want. Very cool. I had it listed for like $12 and someone sent me an offer for $8. $8. So I went ahead and accepted that offer. I felt like that was fair for this hat. I only paid $2 for it. So my earnings are actually $5 before my cost of goods. So not a huge flip, but it was easy to list and it's a fun piece. I was just excited to have that. Next is a really good sale. And this is one of the bolos that I want to share with you. If you're not already selling Guitar Hero or Rock Band stuff, you should definitely look into it and don't be intimidated to ship it out. Okay. That being said, I have a Gibson Explorer Guitar Hero wired guitar. Yeah, I guess this is basically a controller for the game. This one is Xbox, and you can see that because it has it there on that little emblem. And then you can also, when you are sourcing these, this label on the back will tell you a lot of information. This says Explorer Controller. I knew it was an Explorer because my husband used to have one of these in red though. But anyway, this is such a great sale. Guys, I sold this for $90 with free shipping. Let that sink in, $90 free shipping. Now, other guitars sell for different prices. The Explorer seems to do really well. Other guitars, it depends on if it is a wireless guitar and requires a dongle to play, and if it has that dongle. A dongle is basically an adapter that lets the controller speak to the system. So those are things to look out for. They still sell, but for far less money. So this has the cord and it's a popular model, so that's why it sold for so high. But I did look up comps and they were selling for anywhere from $60 to $90. So I priced that $90 and it sold in 1 day. So I'm really excited about that. And what's also cool is I actually made the sale while I was on the beach this weekend. Now, when I say on the beach, I am in the Midwest. So we were at a lake, but I was celebrating my best friend's daughter's birthday at the beach. I had no signal. And when I came back home, I saw that I had the sale. I was like so excited. So yeah, I'm actually going to do a ship with me video on how to box this up. It's far more simple than you would expect. So anyway, look out for that video because I'm going to box it up, ship it today, and then I'll have the video prepared soon after. So yeah, Bolo, Guitar Hero stuff, video game stuff in general is doing so well right now. I'm gonna place it over here actually. It's doing so well right now and people are just really looking for those accessories in particular. So yeah, yay, good sale. The next one, not a good sale. It is a Blackhawks t-shirt that has been listed forever. I got this for free. Did I mention that the guitar I also got for free? Yeah, crazy, from the same person. So this friend of mine will give me inventory here and there. And I think she must have seen that I posted about guitars. So thank you, Sarah, so much for gifting me that amazing guitar. And occasionally I'll give her things that are listed in my closet. But yeah, this is an item that I received from her. And you know, it's a nice t-shirt, Blackhawks, you know, Chicago hockey. But it had been listed for a very long time with little attention. So someone sent me an offer for $5 and I accepted it on Poshmark. What's funny too is that, so on Poshmark, you can see kind of the history of the back and forth of your interactions with the people that like your items. So someone sent me a $5 offer on that t-shirt. And when I went to open it, I saw that like in February, they had sent the same offer and I countered. So I think I had it listed for 10. They sent me an offer for $5. I probably countered at like $7, which felt silly, but like, come on, like $5, you make nothing. And they just declined it. So then here we are, months later, they sent me the same offer. I went ahead and accepted it. Don't be greedy. So I made $2 on that shirt. But hey, you know what? It's keeping items out of the landfill. Someone's gonna be able to rep their team. Like, it's all good. Next, I have a t-shirt bundle. Not super exciting. I'm not even gonna get the shirts out. These are my son's t-shirts, some of which actually, like, I think most of these are hand-me-downs or from Goodwill in the first place. He wore them a bunch and then grew out of them. And so I was going through my like personal death pile, which is like clothes that we kind of purged from our own closets recently, and decided to list some of the kids' stuff in bundles. So I had this listed for $12 on Poshmark and all the platforms, I suppose, somewhere around $12. And I did a price reduction on closet clear out day on Friday, and I reduced it to $10. Now, one thing about Poshmark's closet clear out deal is that if you reduce it below $10, the buyer will not get the reduced shipping. So that's something that's very important to remember. You can't reduce it to $9 and get them reduced shipping. It's very frustrating. So anyway, I had this list at $12, and then when a few people liked it this week, on Friday, closet clear out day, I went ahead and reduced it to 10, and someone made that purchase and they got discounted shipping. So that's exactly what I was hoping would happen when I reduced the price of this bundle. So I'm really glad it worked out. So after Poshmark's fees, I make $7 off these t-shirts, but I'm happy once again to move them to a new home, and you know, maybe I have $7 into it in the first place. So yeah, really happy about that one. There's some fun ones in there. It's kind of like a nerdy, like superhero theme. There's like Lego, Star Wars, Black Panther. It's a good little bundle. All right, so then the last piece that I sold is my other bolo that maybe you weren't expecting. I'm so excited about this one because it also sold in one day. And this is a bundle of some 70s picture frames. What am I trying to say? Sorry, I like had a huge buildup and then just totally dropped what I was gonna say. But yeah, so these are two framed pictures. They do have a glass frame, and they're in these beautiful, like ornate, they are a plastic frame, but these beautiful gold, like floral frames. These pictures are so much my great grandma. Like she had, her whole house was decorated with these like country scenes and like barns and stuff like that. It really made me think of her. I especially love this one with the daisies. They're so pretty. I listed these for $30 on pretty much all the platforms, and they sold in a day on Facebook Marketplace. And what's awesome about Facebook Marketplace is not only did the buyer pay for shipping, but they have the smallest seller fees. So I made like $28 off of this sale, and I'm so excited because I think I paid $2 or $3 each for these. Now I did decide to sell them in a set because when I was looking online at comps, I was finding a lot of actual sets similar to this, like the exact same print. Like it seemed like these were two in the series. Boom, right there. That one's really pretty too. It's got like a country house and a bridge. Sorry if you hear my dog click clacking. She's getting interested in what I'm talking about. But anyway, when I was looking these up, I found a lot of references to the artist, which I think said F. Massa. And although this was not signed anywhere that I could find, I did say Frank Massa style, just in case it wasn't actually, maybe it was a reproduction or I don't know. So some I did see online with a signature. Mine do not have a signature. So yeah, I hope I didn't underprice these because they did sell so quickly, but $30 for these two picture frames. I'm so excited. Good bolo. country. This is like one of those things where I have a backstory. Like, okay, someone's decorating their boho Airbnb and they just need some like country vibes. can you tell I'm going on vacation? I've been looking at a lot of Airbnbs. So anyway, that's my weekend what sold for you. I'm looking so forward to making that shipping video on the guitar. I'll have that out by tomorrow, friends. And then also some Colorado footage. You know, I'm hoping to go to the Denver bins. I'm hoping to meet some friends. People say thrifting in Colorado is the best. So I'm definitely going to be making some time, especially because we are actually driving out there with the children, but we are driving in my husband's truck. So there will be plenty of space in the back to just load up. I'll probably take like a plastic tote and just fill her up. I'm so excited. So anyway, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think of some of these items that I sold today. And let me know, are you going vacationing soon? And will you be thrifting if you do so? The answer for me is always, always yes. All right, thank you so much, friends. I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Bye.